Today, I'm starting a new sketchbook. This is from Ohuhu. This is their mixed media sketchbook, and I really like it. They also sent me these little brush pens. They're like kind of like the Tombow brush pens for calligraphy. They've got like a really nice brush tip. Pigeon really likes the sketchbook. I was pretty excited to start working with these. I really like brush pens. While they did have a lot of colors, I honestly don't think that they had enough shades. Like this little background pink was the lightest I could find. Also noticed that it was kind of easy to overwork an area. The paper would get all pilly, but I do really like the paper. You can see that it was really, really streaky, so I decided to go in with a green, and maybe that would help. I don't know. While I do really like Ohuhu, I don't think that these markers are really for me, but I had a lot of fun doodling and having a good old time. Let me know your thoughts. Drawing Adventure Time characters without a reference, part 13. First, I got Hudson Abadir, okay? Not Hudson, ridiculous, I know. I love his character design so much. I did not do well. I did not do it justice. He's looking like somebody. I don't know who that could be, but we'll get over it. Next, I got Death, probably because this is the 13th video. It just fits. Anyway, I did not have the right picture in my head. I gave him a little flower. I gave him a cane. He's a gentleman. I got James Baxter for my last character. He's a horse. I hate drawing horses. He looks like a guitar, okay? Like a guitar horse. I made him a toothpaste tube, okay? It's cool. Yeah, I added more names, so we're just gonna keep going until we run out.
Ted,
what color is an orange?
Ted, you bonehead. Its color is the same as its name, just like a lemon.
Tell them to watch me. I'm on the loose, out of control. Nothing can stop me. I'm on the phone. Give me a minute. I'm talking to Pop.
I'm going to cry about this and whine about that when you grow up here.
It's Inktober, and here are the art supplies that I'm using. First, I've got this Dr. P.H. Martin's Bombay ink in sepia, and then a De La Rowney ink in black. I absolutely love working with these inks. You can get a nice gradient with them, you can layer them, and they're super, super opaque, which makes them really fun to work with. Now for the paper I'm using, Strathmore Artist Tiles. I got the Bristol, they're only 20 sheets, so I did have to buy two. And you know, if ink is involved, I'm using my favorite brush pen. I got this other brush pen that's a little bit thicker. And then I got this Faber-Castell green brush pen that is absolutely gorgeous. And of course I have to get something to add sparkles and highlights, so I have this Copic Opaque White ink. I have never used this before and I absolutely love it. And then I got some little detail brushes. That's it for me, but what are you gonna use this year?
Imagine if you, like, painted your nails and dyed your hair the same color today. Just do it, like, right now. Oh my god, stop, I can't.
See that person over there? Stab them and fuck the wound.
I'm sorry,
drawing Adventure Time characters from memory. Who knows what part this is, because I do not. First, I got Gumball Guardian, and let me just tell you, I was way too confident, as usual, because my version kind of reminds me of somebody else. Don't know who that would be. Anyway, next, I got Ricardio. I got the weirdest characters this time. Ricardio is super disturbing. Anyway, the last character I got was Baby Finn, which just to me just looks like Finn. But yeah, that was it. Anyway, it's been a while. My life has been kind of crazy, but hopefully we can finish this series. Goodness. All right, bye.
Shut up!
I'm going to kill the next person I fucking see, I swear to God.
Hello, hi, I'm so happy to see you.
Hey, oh my god.
Today I'm trying a new watercolor palette, and I have some pretty high standards. Grabby was kind enough to send me their 100 watercolor palette. I've seen this all over my For You page, and I had to try it out. Comes with a bunch of really cool stuff, and these colors are really pretty. They're really vivid. I like how they go on. This pearly metallic one was one of my favorites, and I also really like the fluorescence. I really like bright colors. There are some that are kind of the same, but I think that's to be expected. Of course, I gotta use the green. This palette is pretty inexpensive. For all the colors that you get, it's honestly a pretty good deal. If you're a beginner or you just want a cute little travel palette, I definitely recommend it. So overall, I give it like a 8.5, 9 out of 10. Pretty good. I mean, look at these colors. You can't beat it. Okay, bye.
Cause I'm black, I already won.
Long Adventure Time characters without a reference, part 14. First, we got James. He's an ice cream sandwich, I think. He's from a few episodes. He's a great character. If you know, you know. He's pretty simple, so there you go. Next, I got Huntress Wizard. I could not remember what she looked like to save my life. She looks like a high schooler who does archery on the weekends, and I'm kind of cool with it. The last character I got was Davy. If you know who Davy is, he's Finn when Finn doesn't want to be Finn anymore and he becomes Davy. Just an average guy. And that's what I drew. Anyway, it was fun. It was simple. I'm ready for some challenging ones. What series do you want to see next? We're almost done. Drawing Bob's Burgers characters in my style. This time we got Gene. It's been a long time since I've made one of these videos, and the truth is, I didn't want to continue this series. I didn't feel good about the finished products, and it didn't feel like my style at all. So this time I wanted to do something a little different, something that truly reflected my art style. The way I draw is messy, and that's the art I make. It's messy, the lines don't connect, everything's a wreck, but that's how I like it, and that's what feels like my art, so that's what I did. I filled up the page with a bunch of little doodles, and I really like how it came out. I even like how there was still a little red on this marker crayon that I used, and it kind of made it messier, which I love. Anyway, that was it. I think it looks really good, and I think this is how I'll continue doing this series. But anyway, I love this show, I love the characters, and I'm excited to see who we get next. Okay, bye.
I've had 10,000 people ask me to do a tutorial on how I draw hair at some point, and I figured, you know what? It is well overdue. I do not gatekeep. So let's go ahead and get into it. Doing a quick slow pan over my Sona. I always update their hairstyle to what I currently have. There you saw braids, and then this was a mission. This is a character who had locks, just to show a difference. All right, so we're gonna start out with braids. So what you're gonna see here is this very specific pattern that I use. It's kind of like just drawing figure eight over and over and over again. And it's a really easy pattern to do for me personally. I literally will kind of just guide out how I want to draw the braid or where the placement is gonna be. I go over again with this pattern, and then I just keep doing that until, you know, voici. This is what you have here, and this is the completed look of that. As a bonus, I'm throwing in twists. They're a little bit different, so instead of a figure eight pattern, I'm kind of just doing S's that kind of gets connect. Words. I do not know how to describe it. However, it's another very repetitive pattern that I kind of just continue to do until I can fill everything in, as you see here. So instead of allowing the pattern to crisscross, just leave it as S's as I do, and then this is kind of the completed look you get. It's a little bit different. And then last but certainly not least, we have locks. I have a love-hate relationship with drawing locks because, as you can see here, I'm just using thin, fine lines to kind of just loop around over and over and over again. The thing with locks is the hair is much tighter together. You can actually see the texture because I'm going to show some examples at the end. But it's basically going to wrap around like a little ring, as you can see. So I keep doing that thin, fine line pattern over and over again. And while it's the easiest for me to do, this one takes the longest because I want to show how close together the hair is and how textured it is here. So yeah, we being extra for no reason. Alrighty, and we have the completed look. And with each and every look, I kind of just add loose hair or like flyaway strands, however you want to word them or whatever, I guess. I feel like it gives it some more character. Want to show some real life examples of braids so you can see why I do the figure eight and how it connects here. And then for twist and everything, the little S shape that I kind of do, you can kind of see why I do that here. And then last but certainly not least, we have the locks. And those little ringlets that you see is the reason why I have everything so closely knit together. So when you look at those examples, and then you look back to everything I have done, you can at least kind of see my logic and reasoning as to why I do what I do and how extra I am. So I hope that helps.
That ding pussy come with liquor. You a pervert, you can kick dirt. What's my name is JG Dickhard. Number 877, get lost, cause it's my pussy. So fuck off! It's icy, you the type of bitches, they gotta check in with the
queen. I'm the alpha, the omega, everything in between.
Ride with the mob, holla to Allah. Check you and me, and do your job. Bird get the name, then baller did the chain. Turn on for the watch, pretty plain Jane.
A cute dog.
Aw, thanks. He's bilingual. That means he likes boys and girls.
No, that's,
No, shh. It's okay, man. I still love you. Not like that, love you, but I still love you, man.
Babe, no, I would never try and break your heart. You only have one. It's irreplaceable. Your bones, on the other hand. You got a lot of bones.
After you drink it, you turn into Ligma.
What's Ligma?
All for nothing at all.
Up about some guy.
This one is different. He's honest and he's sweet.
Please.
He would never do anything to hurt me.
He's a guy.
Did he wanna get to know me? I said, boy, just bend me over.
I ride him and suck him, lick him and fuck him, then I duck him. I ride him and suck him, lick him and fuck him, then I duck him.
Sympathetic, I'm doomed.
I am not a doll.
You are. You do anything you're ordered to, doll.
Bitch, I wake up no stylist. Fresh as fuck, I put it on. No, I did this shit. Then it's fine. Hold no makeup, and she's still a daddy shit.
I have to.
Why?
Because if I don't. That means that all the damage I got isn't good damage. It's just damage.
I hate summer. I hate her crooked teeth. I hate her 1960s haircut. I hate her knobby knees. I hate her.
から始まって切れ終わる言葉5文字炊飯器4文字すき焼き3文字すてき2文字好き私も好き
Never back down, never what?
Never give up
Never back down, never what?
Never give up
Let's get it, let's go!
Touch me
Hey, wanna listen to some tunes?
Yo, MF Doom.
Cat, hold on, summer car, Peter, 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 this you? This you? This you? This you? This you?
I'm not gonna be able to do that.
and win. Ooh. Lean to the left and win. Ooh. Lean to the right and win. Ooh. Lean to the left and win.
Ghosting, fuck it up. Ghosting, fuck it up. Ghosting, that's what's up. Ghosting, hey boo boo, too much complexity to learn me from Google. My mama told me that the money outgrew you.
My car, so you
watch your tone. I'm sensitive and will cry